I planted and have been growing a Hoya plant for some years now and was hoping it would bloom. But it was not mature enough, or something was up, because it never seemed to make its flowers grow enough to actually bloom. They would sprout on the stem of the plant, but after some time, they would just wither and die. I was loving it dearly, and really offered my support as well as I could, hoping one day to see its wonderfully, geometrically perfect flowers. What happened very recently is that, while it was again forming its buds, I witnessed my hand suddenly breaking off one from the stem. My gesture startled me, as it was not intended nor expected. My biases would not let me hurt the plant this way, yet I did not linger much on this thought. At that time, I was immersed in Luhan's teachings while I was participating in the group online sessions, where we were learning about the principles that are deeply explained in Luhan's new book, The Power of Emptiness. I was also blessed to be able to read a first draft of the book and got to ask questions based on the material presented. What a joy! In the book, Luhan relates one story where the flowers of a tree need to be taken off in order for that tree to give more fruit. This explanation is necessary so as to give more background onto my doing. Coming back to that, several days passed by and the Hoya changed. It started to grow one bud bigger than others. There was my hope. I waited patiently and checked on it every day. Some time went by and the flowers fully opened. I was amazed and grateful to finally see it there, not really having expectations for other buds to grow. I was content. But soon enough, the plant got many buds. They are growing into little pink star-like unopened flowers all over the stem and will soon bloom. I am humbled and blessed to know they will have met their purpose in the end. I told this story as it reveals my realizations while admiring this plant. True teaching spirals into fractals to be seen and realized. The truth of Luhan's teachings sprang forth into existence to bloom into my heart. The mystery of how reality arranges itself to mirror back those teachings is beyond rational understanding of things. It just reveals itself into powerful manifestations of wisdom that beacon one's awareness to notice it is called. How to respond to that? I follow Luhan's teachings and stay true to my heart. Returning to my story, I also realized that a kind heart is not always enough to be of service to the situation. It takes discernment and taking responsibility for the present moment. Fully aware that our doings have implications that, like fractals, sprout. It is a constant work of waiting in devotion and sincerity, while making yourself fully available to what is calling for your presence. Being of service is not being good. Being of service is not being bad either. Being of service is being so empty of yourself that you allow true being to appear. Then witness that. Have I answered your question? Luhan often asks. He always answers my questions, even before I get to ask them out loud. And what is most amazing to me is that his answers are so profound in their simplicity, yet so complex in their manifestation. Therefore, the story of the Hoya plant. I am profoundly grateful to have met Luhan and study Lobam Pai on the path of my life. It has had tremendous implications, and I am perpetually renewed. Like a beacon guiding me home, Luhan's teachings are deeply transformational and liberating, and so beautiful. Forever grateful to you, Luhan, with all my heart. Janina.